Hi there. In this video, I want to show you a couple really useful tools, particularly when it comes to building injection molded parts in Solidworks. That's the shell tool and the rib tool. I'm going to go ahead and open a sketch on the top plane, and what I want to do is I'm just going to build a simple box that's going to be injection molded with some reinforcing ribs. So if I grab my center rectangle tool, I'm just going to go ahead and draw a little box here. Maybe we'll make it a 3x5 box. Okay, fully defined. I can go to Features, Extrude, and I'll pop that box up maybe an inch and a half. Let's see. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Okay, and if it's going to be injection molded, it's really going to have a thin wall, and I want to smooth out some of these corners. So I'm going to go ahead and put a fillet on the corners, and let's make that radius a quarter of an inch. And we'll, oops, that's not the edge I wanted. I'm going to go ahead and grab the top surface. And then each of the corners. Notice that I can select right through the surface. I don't even have to rotate it. And once I have all my edges in the surface used, I'm going to go ahead and do that. Now, what I really should have done in this extrusion, right, since I was extruding that, let's go back and edit that. Since it's injection molded, I should put add some draft. Okay, and draft makes it easier to pop out of a mold, so I'm going to go ahead and just give it 1 degree. All right, and everything's looking pretty good here. I could change my view if I wanted to get rid of tangent edges, but for now I'm going to go ahead and just leave it as is. Now I want to make this a thin feature, meaning that I just want this to be a thin shell of injection molded plastic, and SolidWorks has a great tool for that called Shell. When I click on Shell, what Shell asks for is the thickness that you want to keep the wall at, and then what surface is going to be the open surface. So I'm going to come down here, I'll keep it at a tenth of an inch, and I say I want that surface to be the open surface. Now, notice that my mouse icon shows a green check mark on the right button. So if I just click the right button, it says OK, and it cuts out all the material, leaving it just a tenth of an inch thick wall. Now, this is really handy. This would have been very difficult to figure out. Keeping track of my radii on the inside and on the outside, as well as the draft in order to build this box. Very handy tool. There's a couple other things I need to do now, though. Maybe I want to put some reinforcing in this, some ribs that run across it. You're probably used to seeing that. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and insert a plane, and I'm going to offset the plane from the top of this box here. Okay, and when I offset the plane, I'm going to change the directions. Oh, no, I want it that direction, and I'm going to say I want these guys to be at about half an inch. I want my ribs to be just about, well, let's make it 3/4 of an inch tall. Okay, so there's my plane. I'll hit check there. Now I'm going to open a sketch on this plane. Okay, so now I'm drawing right on the plane that's kind of floating in space. And let me get perpendicular to that. All right, now I'm going to grab a line tool and I'm going to grab right on that circle or the edge of the fillet there and come all the way out across and down to this edge over here and we'll make it go right there. Okay, and I'm going to grab the line tool again over here. Okay, I'll come out, grab right there. Come down and grab right on my circle here. Okay. And now I'm going to make sure that these guys pass through the origin by making them coincident. Okay. So now I have these lines, they pass right through the origin. And actually, I should change where this guy lands. By removing the coincident there, I actually want him to be coincident out here. Okay, so that one's fully defined. And then this one, let me get it in the right spot. That one's fully defined. Okay, now I have my two fully defined lines, and I'm going to go ahead and build a feature from these called a rib. So using the rib tool, it takes those and it says, okay, which direction do you want to go? And you can see the little arrow here indicating that it's going down. I can choose the thickness of my rib and I can choose the 1 degree draft. All right, so let's go ahead and click check. And you'll notice that it's gone ahead and added those ribs. Now it looks like it's drafting the wrong direction. It looks like it's getting thinner as it goes down. So we can go back and edit that. And on the draft, we can choose which direction to draft those. All right. Draft outward is checked now. And I'm going to go ahead and hit check. There we go. Okay. I could now go back in and maybe add a circle in the middle or some screw holes or things like that. But that was a very quick and dirty way to build a part that could be injection molding. SOLIDWORKS has tons of other tools here. There's a draft check tool, so you can use that as well, and we'll cover that in future videos. Thanks so much.